I would like to declare tonight a celebration of artistic expression. All audience members will refrain from taking pictures with a flash because harm may come to my royal subjects, and that just won't do. I also declare that everyone in attendance tonight will turn off their cell phones. No, not silent, off. I personally want to thank all of you for purchasing tickets and supporting this kingdom of magic, music, and mayhem. Without you, this show would not be possible. Please feel free to purchase from the vendors so that Legendary Theater may continue to prosper. It's official that you will enjoy yourself this evening. As your ruler, I command it.
It's a really fun experience being on tech. You get to see everything that happens, everything that goes on. You're like, you are the base of the entire show. So it's just really fun to be with a bunch of really cool people.
Tonight is our closing night, which is quite terrifying because this is my last show at high school. Everybody, good luck. Or break a leg. That's the word for tech people.
I'm Haley Reheis, and what I do is carpentry. Have fun and enjoy yourselves tonight because it's the last night.
Hi, I'm Brenda Nelson. I'm a freshman, and I am on carpentry, lights, paint, and props crew. Well, I was offered to be part of the show and hide in the bed and then get pulled out during the finale and run off stage.
So you're going to do that tonight, right?
No, it's too unsafe.
On a crowd of stitch, I was on paint crew, and I am on run crew for backstage left. I would like to especially thank Holly Dykstra for putting up with me and giving me this chance.
I'm on the stage left run crew. I want to say that they're the most amazing crew and amazing cast ever.
Good luck or break a leg tonight. It was really fun to be part of the crew family. And so have fun. We're going to miss all the seniors that are leaving us.
Favorite memory? Probably would be the experience working with my spotlight operators and with the stage manager.
Thanks a lot, guys. You did a really good job, and I'm really proud of all of you.
Shout out to the seniors who are leaving. I love you all.
It's my last year, so I just want to thank Mr. Dykstra and Ms. LaChance and Doc for this past year for having such an amazing theater and theater program, because it's just really, it's made me who I am, and I wouldn't miss it. I wouldn't exchange it for the world.
You are an amazing group of people.
Silence for the crowd tonight, because we're gonna kill them.
Divided we fall. Let's make this show the best one of all. Yeah! put 20 downy mattresses upon her bed.
And beneath those 20 mattresses,
I'll place one tiny pea.
If the pea disturbs her slumber,
then a true princess is she.
Many versions of this story. I know them all. This one was the prettiest, but it's not quite accurate. I happen to know the true story of the princess and the pea, for the very good reason that I was there. It was a small kingdom, ruled over by a talkative queen and a mute king. The princess in the true story was not the only princess put to the test. Actually, she was one of 13. 13 princesses who came with hopes to wed the prince, but for one reason or another were found to be unsuitable. As a matter of fact, the day I arrived, they were just testing princess number 12. A curious quiz was in progress.
Are you ready for the next question?
I guess so.
The next question concerns famous rulers. Are you quite ready?
Uh-huh.
Well then, name 3 kings. Is that clear?
Yes. Wait, what was the question?
Name 3 kings.
Is this a trial?
No, it's the royalty test to see if she's a true princess.
Does it matter if she's a true princess?
Of course. If she's a true princess, we can all get married.
King John, King Arthur, and King Ethelred?
That is absolutely correct.
Oh, she's smart, Mama. She's the best one yet. Can I marry her now, huh? Can I?
No, sweetheart. There's still one more question.
This test isn't going to be fair.
It's the law that isn't fair.
Law?
Yes, the marriage law. Throughout the land, no one may wed till dauntless to the altar is led.
Dauntless?
The prince. Until he gets married, none of us can.
You have now reached the 7th plateau, and here is your final question. It is divided into 4 parts and concerns a famous man often referred to as the Knight of the Red Cross. Number 1, what was his name? Number 2, what beast did he slay? Number 3, how many rows of teeth did the beast have? And what kind? And number 4, what was the middle name of the daughter-in-law of the best friend of the blacksmith who forged the sword that killed the beast?
1, St. George. 2, the dragon. 3, 12 rows of teeth, and they were iron. 4, could you please repeat the last question?
What was the middle name of the daughter-in-law of the best friend of the blacksmith who forged the sword that killed the beast?
The middle name.
The middle name.
Of the daughter-in-law?
In-law, you have 30 seconds.
Oh, pass. Please pass.
Do you speak, my lady?
20 seconds.
I wish her success. She's a pretty little thing.
10 seconds. I'm terribly sorry. Your time is up.
Too bad, my dear. Too bad. You do show a certain aptitude, but as for true brilliance of royalty, well, I'm afraid not. Remember, blood will tell, and yours didn't tell us quite enough. But to show there are no hard feelings, here's a nice consolation prize for you. Goodbye, good luck, and get out! Sweetheart Dauntless, stop pouting. Come along, Dauntless, don't dilly-dally, it's nearly time for your cocoa.
Oh, I liked her. Why must every princess get the bird?
I've never heard of a test so difficult to pass.
Alas, alas, is what I lack. I lack, alas, alas, a whack.
Throughout the land, no one may wed till God.
Gentlemen, two,
four, 16, 10, 11, 12 contenders in a row. They came, they were tested, and swiftly requested to go for a princess, for a genuine certified princess. Tell us when you intend to send us a girl who can pass.
Get the prince, the royal wife.
You are just arrived.
Yes, I am, Sir Wizard.
Splendid, splendid. Watch closely. I take a perfectly plain piece of parchment with no cuts, folds, creases, or concealed pocket. What is it?
Excuse me, Cardamon, but I have to take the minstrel to sign in with the castle steward.
This way, please.
I'm on my way to Normandy. I won't be staying long.
For your father's sake, I put up with a good deal from you. Don't address me as Cardamon in court. Just because your father and I were in show business together, don't presume.
Oh, Sir Harry!
My darling, you missed the test.
Sweet Larkin, my new responsibilities as chivalric knight of the Herald keep me busy.
The latest princess was a failure.
No.
Yes.
Bad luck, but don't despair. If a new princess is not found in the next few months, I'll go out and find one myself, or I don't deserve to wear my spurs.
Darling.
My love?
Do you remember the royal joust on Whit Sunday when you won those spurs?
Of course.
When you were called Sir Harry, the fairest and bravest knight in all the land, and everyone agreed you had a brilliant future ahead of you, you might someday become Lord Chamberlain or even Prime Minister.
Well, I don't know about Prime Minister.
And do you remember the picnic we had later on the greensward with the lovely cold pheasant?
Yes.
And you and I wandered away from the others to climb the hill and watch the sun go down?
Yes.
And a lark was singing in the trees, and you said you'd remember that moment forever because the lark song reminded you of my name?
Yes, Larkin, yes.
And we climbed the hill to watch the sun go down?
Yes.
Well, I'm going to have a baby. So you see, a princess for dolls must be found, and sooner I shall have to go away somewhere. Oh, darling, I'm so worried this could ruin you, and you'd never be prime minister or anything. Just say the word, Harry, and I'll go far away where they'll never find me. Just say the word.
No, you'll stay here. Why should we both suffer all our lives just because you had a moment of weakness?
Oh, Harry.
We're none of us perfect. Everything's going to be all right.
Thank you, Harry.
It won't be long, it won't be long, it won't be, 'cause it can't be long before our dreams come true. Because you know I don't belong, and furthermore, I shan't belong to anyone but you. In a little while, just a little while, you and I will be one, two, three, four. In a little while, I will see your smile on the face of my son, to be forever and in love. It's the way I have it planned, but of all me saying love, if the glove contains your hand.
In a velvet gown, I'll be crewed down the aisle, and it's bound to seem as though the waiting's only been a little in a little while.
Have you any idea how soon, my love?
November.
November?
My time is at premium, for soon the world will see me. I'm eternal bride to be. I know I mustn't worry, Harry. Still, I wish you'd hurry, Harry. Harry, marry me. In a little while, just a little while, you and I will be one, two, three, four. In a little while, I will see your smile on the face of my son, to be forever and in love. Is the way I have it planned, but I'll only stay in love if the glove contains your hand. I can see it all down to every small detail, so I wish you'd look around until you found a castle in the neighborhood for sale.
Come along, darling, don't dawdle. Dauntless, pick up your feet, and don't squint. I told you not to look at the sun. It's better. Sextimus, if I told you once, I've told you 100,000 times, I will not have you running around and playing these foolish games in the halls. It just isn't dignified. We are the rulers of the kingdom, and if we don't set a proper example for the rest of the court, I'd like to know who would. I mean, what's the point of being a ruler if one isn't going to behave as a ruler should?
Mama?
Now what?
Mama, when am I going to get my princess?
Dauntless, I don't want to discuss that now. It's nearly time for your cocoa.
But Mama, sometimes you get the funniest feeling that you don't want me to get married.
Don't what? Don't want you to get married, Dauntless! Don't you trust me?
Well, of course, Mama,
well,
but
then how could you say such a thing? I want you to get married. How many times have I said to you, I want you to get married? I mean, only this morning I was talking to your father. I was saying, Saximus, I want that boy to be married. It just isn't normal for a boy that age to stay single. And after all, he is the prince. I said, just remember, he is next in line for the throne. And we may not be the oldest people in the world, but on the other hand, we're not going to live forever. And I know I just feel much more relaxed in my mind if that boy were married and settled and set. And that is absolutely, verbatim, exactly what I said to your father this morning.
Oh.
Of course, he didn't say anything. He never does. But you know him just as well as I do, and I don't have to tell you how impossible he is. But I don't want you to worry your head one tiny bit about the fact that your father and I don't get along and never have. But that's my cross of pain. If he makes me miserable and makes me suffer, that's just something I'll have to put up with. And I will not allow it to affect my child's attitude towards him or me. He may be a mean, stupid, rotten, dreadful, selfish man. But he is your father, and I want you to respect him. There is only one person who really cares about you and really worries about your health, your happiness, and your future. And that's what I'm talking to you about right now, your future. And I want to make myself absolutely clear that I want you to get married, but I don't want you to marry just anybody. After all, marriage is a lifetime partnership, and I wouldn't want to see my little boy make the same mistake as I did and wind up miserable. The way I did. You are a prince, and you must marry someone suitable. Someone who's good enough, smart enough, and fine enough for my good, nice, sweet, beautiful baby boy. And that's why she must be a princess. I mean a real princess. That's the one thing I absolutely insist upon. She must be a real, genuine, bona fide princess, just as I was. That's what you really want, isn't it? Someone like me? Of course you do. Oh, if I were only 20 years younger. Just remember this. You must trust me.
Your Majesty, Your Highness.
Hello, Harry.
Don't interrupt.
Okay.
Well?
Sir Harry wishes to speak to you, madam.
Well?
Madam, I have the honor to ask a perilous labor. I wish to search for a true princess, one of the royal blood, who will be able to suit both Your Majesty and Prince Dauntless.
No!
Mama!
No, of course not. We've been through all the eligible girls in the neighboring kingdoms, and there are none left. We must wait until their little sisters grow up, and that'll take years.
But madam, I had to plan over the mountains.
Over the mountains?
And across the Badlands.
Across the Badlands?
And into the swamplands where the beautiful marsh lily grows.
Into the swampland? Are you out of your mind?
Oh, let him go, Mama, let him go!
You won't find anything there except for frogs, tadpoles, and things.
Mama, please!
Do you know what the weather there is like?
Mama!
Do you know how damp and foggy?
Mama, please!
And humid and oppressive?
Mama! Let Sir Harry try! For me, Mama! Please, please, for me!
All right, it's your sinus.
Oh, hooray!
Come along, Dauntless, you've missed your cocoa.
Oh, good luck, Sir Harry. Good luck!
Don't worry, little Larkin. I'll be able to bring back a princess who's not only a true princess, but one who will be able to pass all the queen's tests.
I believe you. I'm not afraid.
And I shan't be away long.
Only fly as fast as you can, my love. We shall be waiting for you.
We?
You know. And wear this.
Next to my heart.
Sir Harry's perilous journey took 3 weeks, and Lady Larkin had all but given up hope. But then, one sunny morning in mid-April, when the crocuses were just beginning to dot in the meadows, the North Round Tower spied two distant figures approaching. The alarm was spread. Sir Harry is back! Sir Harry is back with the new princess! Now let's see, how does this go in the old story? On a stormy night, to the castle door, came the lass the prince had been waiting for. That, of course, is utterly untrue. It didn't even storm that night. In fact, it wasn't even night, and the princess had only looked as though she'd come from a storm.
Actually, I swam the moat! But never mind, if I just stand right over here, there's a nice draft. I'll be dry in no time.
You swam the moat?
We tried to stop her, but she wouldn't wait for the drawbridge.
You swam the moat!
She seemed determined to arrive as soon as possible.
We had to use a rope to get her out.
You swam the moat!
All right, I was a little anxious. My friend Sir Harry, oh, he's still out there. He said he had an opening for a princess. Any princess. I figured the early bird! Okay, anyway, here I am. Who's the lucky man? Hey, Nani, Nani, is it you?
Hey, Nani, 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 no.
Hey, Nani, Nani, is it you?
Hey, Nani, 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 no.
Hey, Nani, Nani, is it you? Or you, or you, or you, or...
Nani, nee, nee, noo, nee, nani, nee, nee, noo, nee,
no, no, no.
Someone's being bashful. That's no way to be. Not with me. Can't you see that I am just as embarrassed as you, and I can understand your point of view. I've always been shy, I confess it, I'm shy. Can't you guess that this confident air is a mask that I wear, 'cause I'm shy. And you may be sure, way down deep I'm demure. Though some people I know might deny it, at bottom I'm quiet and pure. I'm aware that it's wrong to be meek as I am. My chances may pass me by, I pretend to be strong. But as weak as I am, all I can do is try. God knows I try. Though I'm painfully shy, and despite the impression I give, I confess that I'm living a lie, because I'm actually terribly timid and horribly shy. Though a lady may be dripping with glamour, as often as not she will stumble and stammer when suddenly confronted with romance. And she's likely to fall on her face when she's finally face to face with a pair of pants. Quite often the lady's not as hard to please as she seems. Quite often she'll settle for something less than the man of her dreams. I'm going fishing for a mate. I'm gonna look in every nook. But how much longer must I wait with bated breath and hook? Done, man. Get on with the fun, man.
I am one man. Shine!
You swam the moat!
Does she ever say anything else except you swam the moat?
Why don't you ask her yourself?
Oh. Do you ever say anything else except you swam?
Do you mean to ask me to believe that you are a true princess of the royal blood? And I'm actually to understand that you have the nerve, the gall, and the presumption to apply for my son's hand in marriage?
Mama, may I say something?
No.
Okay.
Do you even imagine for one moment I would consider you suitable for any son of mine? You are laboring under a very unfortunate misapprehension, my dear. My son isn't going to marry any moat swimmer. Not while I have breath in my body. And I haven't been well. Not well at all. I get these shooting pains all in through here. And don't try to tell me it's the vapors. I know what the vapors are. I've had vapors.
Are you new here? Watch closely. I take a perfectly plain piece of parchment with no cuts, folds, creases, or concealed pockets.
Oh, it's a nut house!
Hey, No, wait.
You're the one, I guess.
Sure, I'm Prince Dauntless, the drab.
Dauntless? Okay, well, glad to have met you.
Hey, no, wait, I like you. Everybody does. Well, almost everybody.
Oh, Dauntless, I'd like to stay here, but I wouldn't want to come between you and your mother. So I guess I'll just face the facts, cut my losses, and head back to the swamp.
But I really like you.
You do? Why?
You swam the moat.
Oh, Dauntless. I know I swam the moat, but I'm not actually like that. That's not the real me. In fact, I'm shy!
Ah, she's in the moat again.
Lower the drawbridge.
Are you all right?
Sure.
You should see her swim, Mama. She's wonderful.
Yes. Isn't she?
I like her, Mama. She swam the moat.
It's gold.
Twice. Can I marry her now, Mama? Huh? Can I? Please, oh, please.
Marry her? Of course not. When you marry, if you marry, you'll marry someone suitable.
I have the honor to announce the arrival of Her Royal Highness, the Princess Winifred.
You're a little late. She's been here and gone.
Gone?
Yes, she's swimming home. That, Sir Harry, is no princess.
Ah, but she is, Your Majesty.
What?
That's one. You jest?
On mine honor as a knight, I swear she is. I have her papers right here. Winifred, Princess of Icomkill, guardian of the Midgard Serpent and warden of the Ragnarok Marsh Lily. The inscription on her family crest reads, Tunisid malis sed contra identior ito.
And what does that mean?
Roughly it means if at first you don't succeed...
Ah, never mind.
You see, she is a princess.
Well, she does look like a princess.
Well, at least a test, Mama. For me, please, Mama, please. For me, please.
All right, we'll test her. The wizard and I will put on our thinking caps and make up a nice, fair test, just as we always do. And I'll prove to you that this girl cannot possibly be a princess.
Get her by the leg.
We'll test her for...
This is her leg.
Oh, that's not my leg. Oh. How crude. Test her for... Sensitivity. She'll have her test, and she'll fail just like all the others, fair and square. Fail what?
Well, the royalty test.
Every princess suing for my hand must pass the test. in order to prove that she's a real princess.
Oh, a kind of test.
Well, it's always highly secret.
Oh, we'll worry about that later. Right now, I better get out of these wet clothes.
Oh, may I show you part of the castle on the way to your room?
Sure.
You're awfully nice.
You're nicer.
And you're good looking, too.
You're better looking. And nicer, too. Oh.
Well, you're a better swimmer.
Your Highness, Sir Harry's back. Oh, yes, he is, and he's brought with him a beautiful princess. Have you seen her yet? Well, neither have I, but I'm sure she's as delicate as an orange blossom. And I'm to be her lady-in-waiting. Sir Harry arranged it. He arranges everything. Isn't he thoughtful?
Well, my father wanted me to follow in his footsteps, and then I landed this jester job, and... Hey, what's wrong? You're worried? Well, about what? Who? A lady? Which lady? Two syllables. First syllable. Bird, some kind of bird. Auk, bluebird, catbird, dove, eagle, finch, grouse, lark, marlin, lark!
Lady Larkin?
Okay. And? A knight?
Which knight?
Sir Harry.
Sounds like... dust. Sounds like dust. Lust!
Must? Must what? Okay, you're gonna start all over, right?
She's in trouble.
What kind of trouble?
Big trouble.
Mm-hmm. How many syllables?
Well, she's going to have a baby?
Who else knows about this?
Sir Harry.
Well, of course Sir Harry knows, but does anyone else know?
Don't worry, Your Majesty. We can keep a secret. The question is, can you?
Well, I mean, of course we know you can't talk, but you still...
No!
You can't talk, but you still manage to communicate.
We have only two voices among us, and yet there's a third voice, a voice in disguise. You'll be hearing a trio and not a duet if you listen with both of your eyes. Kindly, with both of your... We produce a unique and remarkable blend when we raise our three voices on high. We're in perfect accord from beginning to...
The king and the minstrels adore.
Yet if one of our trio should ever depart, then the others would languish and die. We're like three different people with only one, the king and the jester and I. Sing hey nonny nonny, hey nonny nonny, hi diddle diddle. Strike up a tune on the... Oh, the bishop declares our behavior is crude as he piously looks to the sky. 'Cause when we go in swimming, we always go...
See the king and the jester.
The king and the minstrel. Oh, the vintner makes wine from the grapes that he grows. 20 barrels were lost last July. Where they went is a secret that nobody... Oh, the cook claims she's missing one chocolate cream roll and a fish that was ready to fry. Guess who's dining on pastries and filet of... Sing hey nonny nonny, hey nonny nonny, needle and thimble, crash us a clash on the... It's been said of our king that his morals are loose, But the queen is much worse on the slope. Cause what's good for the gander is good for the...
Say the king and the jester.
The king and the minstrel.
Enough trouble trying to protect my only son from every catchpenny princess that comes along. Now I'm surrounded by spies and traitors. Whom can I trust?
Me.
No one. And now I have another one of those princesses to cope with, and I'm in no mood to sit for hours in a stuffy chamber and rack my brain over a test when I'm not feeling at all well. But that's the way Dauntless wants it, and that's the way it'll be. She'll have her test.
Well, her papers seem to be in order.
I know. And the worst of it is that foolish boy actually seems to like the girl. So we must think of a test that looks fair, sounds fair, seems fair, and isn't fair. When you got the idea for testing her for sensitivity, I could have applauded right out loud. But exactly what?
Table manners.
That's not hard enough. Sensitivity, sensitivity, I'm just loaded with that. In this one word is the epitome of the aristocrat. Sensitive soul and sensitive stomach, sensitive hands and feet. This is the blessing, also the curse of being the true elite. Common people don't know what exquisite agony is. Suffered by gentle people like me. Just get your hands off me. Think up a tricky test for that wretched moat-swimming princess.
Madam, may I suggest? Maybe we ought to...
Don't take all night. I'm not well. I need my rest. Not that I'd ever sleep on that lumpy mattress. Oh, God, my back. Sensitivity, bane of royalty. That bed's a torture rack. Oh, I hate to sound grumpy, but my nerves are so jumpy. I am sure I could feel any lump, even if it were under the mattress and as small as a pea. That's the answer! Under the mattress! We'll test her tonight. One tiny pea beneath one thick, downy mattress. Oh, God, you're bright! Any genuine princess would feel it. If she doesn't, she's through. Get the tiniest pea in order. One mattress. No! Make it two! 10, I think, would be plenty. Better still, make it 20. And to play it safe in the event, even that's not enough to ensure that she sleeps. We'll give her a soothing sedative, won't we? You can whip up a drink. Something stunning. Oh, but you're devilish. I love the way you think. She's insensitive, so insensitive. She'll fall asleep, no doubt. God, but you're brilliant, clever, a genius. You are divine. I'm out.
Well, it certainly feels good to get into something dry. This old dress was just soaked.
Excuse me, Your Highness. The king has asked to meet the young lady.
Why? He never asked before.
Well, he heard she
swam the moat.
Oh, Dauntless, is your father anything like your mother? Because if he is,
No. My father is silent.
I'd love to meet him.
Papa, this is Princess Winifred.
Your Highness, the King welcomes you. And he asked me to say that he hopes you'll get 100 on the test tomorrow.
Oh! Thanks!
Oh, my father never touches his crown to his chest unless he really means it.
Alas, madame, the king is mute. Otherwise, he would speak for himself. He's still under a curse cast by a witch long ago, before Prince Dauntless was born. The curse says, King Sextimus will never talk until the mouse devours the hawk.
Until the mouse devours the hawk? Oh, can't you just get a big mouse and a little hawk and then
we tried that once, but the mouse got scared and ran away and the hawk bit daddy.
Oh. Well, just let me get this test under my belt and we'll figure something out. It certainly was a pleasure meeting your majesty. A short while ago, I had the pleasure of meeting her majesty. Ooh, that is a nice man.
Your majesty, I think it's about time you had that talk with Prince Dauntless now about, you know.
About what?
Your father feels as though he's been neglecting his duty, and now that you're old enough to get married, he thinks it's about time you two have a little talk. You know, man to man.
You mean about things? You mean now?
Your majesty feels as maybe it's better to wait until another time. There are some facts he has to look up first. Go!
Oh. Well, I certainly do like almost both your parents, Dauntless.
Well, we want you to be happy here. And we know it's a lot different from what you're used to.
It is a little hard making the adjustment to dry land and everything.
You must be like a fish out of water.
As a matter of fact, I do. You see, where I come from, we don't have any dry land. Oh, some of the poorer people do, but all the nobility live right in the swamp with their servants and pets.
Oh, do you have pets?
Lots.
Dogs?
Frogs.
Wow.
I come from the land of the foggy, foggy dew. Where walking through the meadow in the morning is like walking through glue. The swamps of home are brushed with green and gold at break of day.
At break of day.
The swamps of home are lovely to behold from far away. In my soul is the beauty of the bog. In my memory, the magic of the mud. I know that blood is thicker than water, but the swamps of home are thicker than blood. Where'er I roam, my heart grows dank and cold. My face grows gray when shadows fall and I hear the call of the swamps of home. I hear them calling me now, calling me back, calling me Winifred, 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 Winifred. Who do you think you are, girl of the swamp?
to bar, made of the marshland. Give up the struggle. Listen to the voice of the swamp. Gluggle, luggle, luggle. Where'er I roam, the whips of fate may smart, but deep down in my heart, one thought will abide and will ne'er be forgotten. Though I search far and wide, there is no land as rotten. As the swamps of home.
Your Majesty, the ladies and I were wondering if we could get you something to wear while your garment is drying.
Oh, why, thanks!
Ladies?
Dauntless,
mm-hmm.
I have to change now.
You do? All right.
Oh, Dauntless, no! It's bad luck to see too much of the bride before the wedding. Come on. Yep, chicka, there you go, just like that. Yep. See you later.
May I show you to your gowns now, Your Highness?
Sure.
Ladies. Now, this first style here is all the rage in Paris. There is the pink chiffon, the beating around the waist, simply wonderful. Next. Oh, the new beautiful gala garment. Oh, notice the gold, the ruffles.
Ruffles.
Baby blue is spring's new color.
Seasons have
notice
colors.
The fullness in the back and the window sleeves. Oh my. How could I forget?
Oh, gorgeous.
Simply stunning, isn't it, Lady H?
Stunning.
Perhaps Her Highness would like to look in a mirror.
Perhaps Your Majesty has a favorite color.
Well, back home we wear a lot of dark green and earth brown, but I suppose my very own dress there was my favorite color. Huckleberry. I'll tell you what. Why don't you leave them all, and the ones I can't use, I'll take back.
Very well, Your Highness. Ladies.
Yes.
Every time. Bye. See you later. Thank you.
Poor lost little lamb.
Oh, there's no way. Oh, God. Oh, dang it. Oh, my gosh.
Now, as soon as we're done up here, I'm going to have you clean the chamber outside, okay? Oh, but it looks like I won't be needing you, Emily. They've sent someone up here to do the floors already. Thank you. You're new here, aren't you?
Oh, yes, I am.
Well, remember, we're all here to do a job, and your job is just as important as everyone else's. Winifred, you will pass the Queen's test. Oh, you will. Grimercy! My dear, you can't possibly clean the floor with such a tiny patch. What you need is a good big wet rag. What's this?
That's my huckleberry.
Use this old thing. Come on. Clean. Do you know what it means to me to be lady-in-waiting to the blessed Winifred? Oh, Winifred, what name is sweeter than that? Look at this room. It's such a mess. What will my gentle princess think of me?
I don't know.
Oh, get that, please. Quick, oh, quick.
Harry!
Your Highness.
Your what?
Oh, Harry, you know you don't have to go through the motions with me. Say, I'm awfully sorry about the whole swimming the moat thing. I hope I didn't make a bad impression.
Not at all, Your Highness. And if you'll just give your wet dress to one of the ladies in waiting, they'll make sure it's taken care of for you.
Oh, thank you. It's already been taken care of.
I see you've met my dear Lady Larkin.
You mean this is Little Larkin girl?
The very same, Your Highness.
Harry! She's beautiful and a bundle of energy.
When I gaze upon that captivating face, I realize how poor my description must have been.
Sir Harry's not very good at describing people, Your Majesty.
Well, he may not know how to describe them, but he sure knows how to pick them. Okay, well, if you'll excuse me, I've got to return these to the fourth floor.
I've never been so humiliated in my entire life.
What's the matter?
I thought she was a chambermaid.
What?
A chambermaid.
Larkin, how could you mistake the princess for a chambermaid?
How could I? How could you mistake that chambermaid for a princess? Don't blame it on me.
I do blame it on you.
She was on her hands and knees scrubbing the floor.
She's a real princess wherever she was. And that's more than I can say for some people around here.
I hate you.
Well, I hate you too.
Get out.
Don't worry, I'm going.
Goodbye.
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 After all, you are a wizard. You should be able to think of something that will help that what's-her-name to sleep. Don't forget to whip up a sleeping potion and some of that good heavy incense and the hypnotic mirror, too. Wait! The most important thing is that she's tired out first. We are to have an official ball tonight, and we'll make what's-her-name dance until she drops. But what can we do? Do you know the Saracen Brawl? No, that's not tiring enough. I have it. We can do that new dance, the Spanish Panic. It's absolutely exhausting. Do you know it? Well, it's the rage in Venice. Everybody listen. We are to have an official ball tonight, and everyone is to attend. We'll be doing that new dance, the Spanish Panic, so you might as well learn right now. The basic step is flip your skirts open, close, right, right, right. It's like the magic step, only forward. You try? Flip your skirts open, close, right, right, wrong. Doesn't anyone here know the Spanish Panic?
Yes, Your Majesty.
Thank goodness someone around here is up to date. Suppose we watch while Sir Harold and Lady Beatrice demonstrate. Now, was that so hard? Suppose we all try. Partner up, please. Prepare. Isn't it wonderful? Doesn't it make you just want to fly?
Sure, you know what you're doing.
Ow.
Oh! Oh! Oh!
What's the matter? You lost her? All right, Your Majesty, I'll help you.
Go again! Whoa!
Trying to kill me.
Has he ever had any success? I've been here a month, and he hasn't caught a girl yet.
Tell you what, Your Majesty. Tomorrow, we'll set a trap.
You exaggerate.
Not a bit. Someone's coming?
Who?
The Queen! Get out!
This has to be the biggest, loudest ball we've ever had. And make sure to hire extra musicians for tonight's dancing. And tell the jester I want him to perform. Although I won't be able to enjoy any of it with my back and that nagging pain in my jaw. No one will ever know what I suffer.
What was all that jabbering about? The Queen is going to make us do something.
What?
Exercise! Someone's coming?
Who now?
I don't know. He doesn't even know.
Well, wait a minute. Can I come in here? Dibs.
Oh, minstrel. Minstrel, no.
Why do I always get stuck with the crappy tent?
Oh, my lady! Is everything all right?
Yes.
Well, we're glad of that anyway.
I was in my room sewing, and it got a little stuffy, so I decided to come out and get some air.
Well, you sure plan to camp out for a while.
Your Majesty, you don't know. You just don't know. Do you have any idea what can happen to the relationship between a man and a woman? I'm glad I found out when I did. It's better this way. I'm leaving.
You're leaving?
Yes, I'm leaving the service of the Queen forever.
That's a pretty big step to take all alone.
I have no choice.
You're leaving forever?
Yes.
Someone's got to come with you.
Who would help me?
I, my lady.
What? You want to help take care of the Lady Larkin? Who's going to take care of you?
Chivalry demands that we protect a damsel in distress.
Well, if you say so, Your Majesty.
Oh, but she'll have to travel light. You know, the way a man does.
No, yes, okay. She'll go disguised as a boy. I should know something about that. We can borrow one of Prince Dauntless's suits. All right, I'm going to take this. You go up to your room.
No,
goodbye.
No, it's really okay. I don't need help from anyone. I can go alone.
Oh, she'll be all right. Once she gets past the water rats.
Rats?
Oh, yes. They lie in the stagnant pools outside of the quicksand.
Quicksand?
Beyond the wall, which you must climb.
Slime?
It's 22 feet and covered with slime.
Slime?
And infested with spiders.
Spiders?
Well, the spiders are sweet compared to the snakes.
Snakes?
On the other side.
Oh, don't worry. They won't hurt you. Unless, of course, you plan to go alone.
Well, I did until I found out how terrible it is out there.
Then you'd think a second thought and come with me. I know all the secret ways to get us free. Over the hills and to the open sea.
Well, then what?
Well, it's April, isn't it?
April?
Normandy is fine and fair. So Normandy is where we'll go.
I can show you a beach where the peach blossom blows. And I know how to reach a man who knows a man who knows a cozy inn.
A friend
friendly place, with rows of windows facing the sea. This time of year, the air I hear is rare and clear and warm in Normandy.
I know a meadow covered with mustard flowers, golden as the sun, where a wondrous thing can happen when an April day is done. There's a moment after the sunset when the sky is suddenly green, and the world stands hushed and waiting for the first white stars to convene. When you see that emerald sky, you'll know the reason why. There's not another place I'd rather be.
It's like heaven, heaven on earth.
Unto hell with Burgundy,
come fly with me.
Come try these wings.
Come swift,
for we have things to do. Is there really a beach where the peach blossom blows? Are you sure you can reach a man who knows a man who knows a
country? Yes, yes, in hand.
A friendly place with rows of windows facing the sea. This time of year, the air I hear is rare and clear, and don't be afraid. Heaven was made in Normandy.
Have you seen Sir Harry? He's had a fight with the Lady Larkin.
Hey, look!
I hear he's with that French girl. She only speaks one word of English, but I hear she's a charmer.
What's the one word?
Yes!
How's it going, Harry, old boy?
Très bien?
After the ball, we're gonna have a little party in the West Parapet. Don't forget to bring the wine.
And something to spread on the ground.
Harry, ask Maybelle if she'd like to bring something.
Voulez-vous...
Yes!
Thank you.
Are you feeling a bit weary, dear?
Weary?
Oh, no!
Let's do it again!
Get up!
Come on! Oh, come on, you guys! Okay, bye! Oh, Thomas! Maybe you could give me a clue!
A clue?
Well, I know it's highly secret, but what sort of test does she usually give?
Well, with Mama thinking it up, it might be almost anything.
Like what?
Well, sometimes it's history.
Oh.
Sometimes it's dancing.
Oh.
Sometimes it's spelling.
Oh.
But sometimes it's a test of strength and endurance.
Aha!
Boom. For instance, one of the girls had to lift this weight. She couldn't. I can't even lift it. But I know you'll pass. You don't have to worry.
Do you want me to pass? Then I'll pass. Here, hold this.
Oh. Oh. Hey, I think you're wonderful.
Oh, no. Oh, by the way, I don't think I ever told you. My full name is Winifred the Woebegone, but Winifred's too formal. You can call me by my nickname.
Winnie?
Fred.
Fred. What a beautiful name. So straight. So strong. So you. I like you, Fred. I like you.
You're just saying those words to be kind.
No, I mean it. I love you, Fred.
He is out of his medieval mind.
Oh, well, perfectly sane and sound. I've never felt better in my life. Everybody, come and meet my incipient wife.
Me?
You.
Hi, my name's Fred. I'm a princess, I hope.
I'm in love with a girl named Fred. My reasons must be clear. When she shows you all how strong she is, you'll stand right up and cheer. I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She drinks just like a lord. So come sing a merry drinking song and let the wine be poured.
All the girls are overflowing. Raise the goblet high. With an F and an R and an E and a D and an F, R, E, Fred.
Yeah. I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She sings just like a bird. You'll be left completely speechless when her gentle voice is heard. Girl named Fred, she wrestles like a Greek. You will clap your hands and wonder at her fabulous technique. Whoa, whoa. I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She dances with such grace. You are bound to sing her praises till you're purple in the face. Whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa, no, no, whoa. I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She's musical to boot. She will set your feet a-tapping when she plays upon her lute.
Party.
I'm in love with a girl named Fred, a clever clownish wit. When she does her funny pantomime, your sides are sure to split.
Pillows.
Right.
Blankets.
Right.
Mattresses.
Right, right, right.
Woo! Yes!
Don't mind me.
Harry!
Oh, Jester! Huh, Jester. Stop him! Bring him here to me! There he goes down the corridor!
You look marvelous.
Kettle of fish.
Yes!
You wretch.
Ow!
The queen!
Come here, right now.
No.
Grab her by the ear.
Let go.
Come here.
Ow!
I knew I couldn't trust you, you wretch. What's all the noise about anyway? Anytime I turn my back, something outrageous is going on in the corridors. I knew I couldn't trust you, you wretch. What's going on around here? What are you up to? What? What's going on around here? What's under the mattress? It's a dead body. Well, what are you doing? Pull that away! Explain yourself.
It's a joke, Your Majesty. This boy and I, go out and wait for me, Lancelot.
Lancelot? Yeah. Wait! Lady Larkin! Bring those things up to what's-her-name's chamber. Mattresses, too.
Your Majesty, I...
Quiet! Why are you in that ridiculous getup?
I...
Silence! And why weren't you at the ball?
Your Majesty, you have to...
Shut up! And why are you with this man?
Well, because I...
Speak up!
I...
You were running away, is that it? You were running away! Why, you low-born, ungrateful little sneak. Is this the thanks I get for treating you as my own daughter? One of my ladies running off with a... musician.
Your Majesty, the Lady Larkin is innocent. I'll tell you the truth. Well, I forced her to leave against her will.
That's not true.
Why, you low...
Just a moment.
Larkin, what are you doing with this man?
What are you doing with this woman?
Yes. Just a moment.
You go to your room.
Don't you tell me what to do, you libertine.
Quiet! May I remind you, Lady Larkin, that you are still one of my ladies-in-waiting? Get above stairs to where you belong and prepare what's-her-name for bed.
But, Your Majesty, I...
Do as I say. And may I remind you, Sir Harry, that you are still one of my knights?
step forward. And you, relax. I want this minstrel banished from my kingdom. He is to be out of here by daybreak.
Yes, Your Majesty.
No. Sextimus? Go to bed. I don't want you groping around in the dark all night.
Yes! Woo! Woo! Yes!
And as for the rest of you, listen closely. There was a little girl upstairs who is dog tired.
Oh no, I heard she was studying for her test.
All right, let her study, but when she's done, I want quiet around here, and I'm going to get quiet, even if I have to scream the palace down. Quiet!
Quiet, quiet. The queen insists on quiet. She's ordered 20 mattresses, the softest and the best.
And she's threatened execution if we dare disturb the rest of our very special.
Some. S. U. M. Some.
Summer.
Summer. S. U. M. E. R. Summer.
Good. Well, if Mama tests you in literature or spelling, you are sure to pass, Fred. That leaves history.
Oh, history. That takes in quite a lot, but let's give it a whirl.
Okay. This first chapter is called The Bravery of Prince Waldare.
Waldare.
Young Waldare, wishing to slay the dragon Fafnir.
Who?
Wishing to slay the dragon Fafnir.
Oh yeah, Fafnir, that one.
Disguised as the west wind goes into the forest and surprises Fafnir in his lair, where he kills him. Whereupon, he is unable to understand the speech of birds. Meanwhile, Waldare's father, Alberic, disguised as the sacred goat, tells him that the spirit of Gunther...
Gunther?
The spirit.
Gunther? But I thought that Gunther was the guy that slayed the dragon.
No.
Oh, did you ring for a page boy?
No.
You got the wrong room, son. Wait. Aren't you Larkin?
Yes, Your Majesty.
What's the matter?
I have a suit just like that.
I was running away.
Oh, I see. We'll sit down and rest.
Oh, but the queen is
ordered. Oh, never mind what the queen's order. Just sit down. Dauntless, pull up a chair.
Oh.
Now, what's this all about?
I'll just go on and stand on the parapet naked and catch a chill and die. That'll show him.
Show him what?
He'll be sorry.
We'll be sorry.
Horrible Harry.
Oh, you mean big, nice Harry?
Wait a minute. What did you do to him?
What did I do to him?
Well, you must have done something. You're looking the way I did once when I was afraid to go home because I'd given my little brother a bloody lip. Oh, it was an accident.
We had a little disagreement.
So you decided to run away?
He said some perfectly horrible things to me.
Oh, okay. I see. Well, I guess about the only thing you can do is pack up and get out.
Yup.
Unless, of course, you go to him and say you're sorry. Come here. Listen, that Harry is a wonderful boy and he really loves you. Why, we were on the road for 2 weeks and he never laid a finger on me.
Oh, Your Highness.
And now you just get into something that shows you're a girl and patch things up with him. Oh, and Larkin, try to act a little helpless. Men don't like girls that are too strong.
Oh, I do. I do.
Oh, Princess, I don't know how to thank you. If it's a girl, I'm naming her Fred.
What if it's a boy?
Dauntless,
You'd better go to bed now and leave the history book.
Well, I'm positive you'll pass Mama's test tomorrow, Fred. Well, I'm pretty sure. Well, if you don't, I'll understand. Okay. Oh.
And so, the young Prince Waldair, having slain the dragon Fafnir with the sword Minning, rescued the Princess Frigga, and together they mounted his horse, Trigga, and they rode to the castle Vundabar, where they were married and lived happily ever after.
Well, I'm glad.
They all lived happily, happily, happily ever after. The couple is happily leaving the chapel eternally tied. As the curtain descends, there is nothing but loving and laughter. When the fairy tale ends, the heroine's always a bride. Ella, the girl of the cinders, did the wash in the walls and the winders, but she landed a prince who was brawny and blue-eyed and blonde. Still, I honestly doubt that she could ever have done it without that crazy lady with the wand. Cinderella had outside help. I have no one but me. Fairy godmother, 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 where can you be? I haven't got a fairy godmother. I haven't even got a godmother. I mean, I have a mother, a plain, ordinary woman. Snow White was so pretty, they tell us, that the queen was insulted and jealous when the mirror declared that Snow White was the fairest of all. She was dumped on the border, but was saved by some men who adore her. Oh, I grant you, they were small, but there were seven of them, practically a regiment. I'm alone in the night, by myself, not a dwarf, not an elf, not a goblin in sight. That girl had seven determined little men working day and night just for her. Oh, sure, the queen gave her a poisoned apple, but even so, she lived happily, happily, happily ever after. A magical kiss counteracted the apple eventually. Though I know I'm not clever, I'll do what they tell me I have to. I want some happily ever after to happen to me. Rapunzel had platinum tresses that were double the length of her dresses, but was kept in a tower for years by a wicked old witch. Till one day in despair down, she scrambled by letting her hair down. That's what I call quite a switch. I wonder, oh, it would never hold. I'd be finished before I begin. And besides, I don't want to get out. I want to get in. I want to get into some happily, happily ever after. I want to walk happily out of the chapel eternally tied, for I know that I'll never live happily ever after. Till after I'm a bride, and then I'll be happily happy. And thoroughly satisfied.
You're a bully and a tyrant. Just because you won your spurs, you think you're
now
so
see
big.
Here. This man is charged with transporting a young woman out of kingdom against her will. That's a serious offense.
He didn't do it. It was a frame-up.
You've got it all wrong.
He was protecting the Lady Larkin. Sir, no, and you stay out of this, Your Majesty.
Sir Harry, I can't leave yet. There's still someone I must see.
Who?
Well, the wizard. I want your permission to see the wizard.
Yes, yes.
No, permission denied.
Sir Harry, you're a fathead.
Yes, you are. Can't you see he's trying to help? We're all trying to help.
How can you help?
By finding out what the test is from the wizard.
Well, that's cheating.
Don't you understand? This is for you.
Let me see the wizard.
No, you have to stand guard. This is my job. No, you can't come. You can't come, and that's final.
What's the matter, Papa?
The king mustn't come with us.
I'll get rid of him. Your Majesty?
Oh.
Prince Dauntless is ready to have that little talk with you. Right now!
Maybe some other time.
No! It's very important that it's had now. It mustn't be put off.
It is.
Do your duty, sire.
Well, Papa, what do you want to talk to me about? What do you want to tell me? Well, Papa, what? Stop. Look. Listen. Little Prince. Boy, flower, girl, flower, boy, flower, girl, flower. Oh, tell me more. I want to know about what getting married is for. Oh, a seed. Fall from girl flower in by and by. Baby flower, grow, oh, but why? Oh, tell me why, oh, father, tell me, father, don't be shy. Oh, boy flower, girl flower, love each other. Boy flower, father, girl flower, mother. Oh, yes, yes, but how? It's very interesting, but how? Oh, tell me now. A bee on boy flower dust gets on bee, bee flies to girl flower, dust touches girl flower, oh I see, no I don't see, it's very interesting but still not clear to me. Woman is like girl flower, man is like bee, and like boy flower. Oh man, that's me! But tell me more. I've got to know about what getting married is for. Sounds like Carrie. Sounds like Carrie. Mary. Man and woman get married. Winifred and White love each other. And then one night, oh, yes, yes, one night, it's very interesting what happens in the night. Oh, what happens? What happens? Oh, tell me, Father, please, shall I go and pick some flowers? Shall I go and catch some bees? Princess Winifred and I will get married. And then, one night, the stork will come and bring us a baby. Oh, Papa, I know all about the stork. Mama told me about that years ago. No, wait a minute, Father. Flower, seed, man, woman, bee, baby, small. It isn't the stork, it isn't the stork, it isn't the stork at all. Oh, life is grand, it's very interesting. I think I understand. I think I know. It's very interesting. Thank you, Father. And Father, I love you so.
Excuse me, Sir Wizard.
What is it?
Our friend, the minstrel, is a great admirer of yours.
No soft soap, if you please.
This is not soft soap, and I wouldn't have to say it except for the fact that, well, I've been banished, and I hope you don't mind me saying this, but before I go, I just had to tell you what a great inspiration you've been to me, Cardamon.
Cardamon? Don't address me by that name. Name. Don't address me by that name. Name. Cardamon, don't address me by that name. Name.
I love this trick.
Oh! Well, I use that name with great honor, sir. I'll never forget that night in Glastonbury in 92. What a show, what a triumph. You took 7 curtain calls.
8.
Do you happen to remember that little boy in the second row who stood up that night and yelled, "Bravo!"
Yes.
Well, I was that boy.
I can't believe it.
And now I'm in show business too, and if it's any interest to you, it was you who bought me on this path.
You must belong to the guild, Camelot's Local 714. Ah, to think that someone still remembers those days.
Yes, well, I just wanted to tell you what that performance did to me. I'd better be going.
No. Stay a while. For you.
Oh, thank you.
Oh. Have a seat.
No, the queen wouldn't like it if she knew I was staying.
Oh, never mind her. Sit down. This is between us.
Well, you're probably busy with that test for tomorrow.
Oh, that's all right. Test is all taken care of.
I don't suppose you could tell an old guild brother what it is?
Well, I'm sort of under oath.
I understand. I'd better be going.
Sir Minstrel, may I borrow your handkerchief?
What handkerchief?
Magical.
Whoa. Cardamon the Great! Oh.
Gets better. One, two, three. Three.
The best one
yet!
Oh,
wow!
Anyways, bet you'll never guess what the test is on.
Astronomy?
Nope, you'll never guess. Sensitivity.
Sensitivity? Oh, did you hear?
Cardamon the Greatest. Now let me tell you the rest. No, I better not.
Oh. I'll go. But before I do, may I ask something?
What is it?
May I have these?
What do you want with that?
Just a memento of the old days, because of my father.
Take it.
Thank you, sir.
Jester?
Oh, thank you, sir.
That was a great thing you did for that kid, Cardamon.
Well, for her father's sake.
Say, I don't actually have to be out of here until tomorrow. What do you say we go down to the cellar, split a bottle, and talk some more about the... Talk some more.
Fine, fine. But I've started something here and I'd like to finish. I'll be there in 2 seconds.
I'll be waiting. What's the matter, Jester?
Oh, nothing.
Hey, tell us a funny joke.
Have you ever heard of my father, Sliding Peter Jingle?
Is that supposed to be funny?
I don't know.
I think the clown has lost his touch.
I'm far from sentimental or romantic. And I like to think I'm strictly up to date.
But at times the dancing gets a bit too frantic in these hectic days of 1428. So indulge me if I pause to raise my chalice to a quaint and charming dance they used to do in the days when my dear father played the police back in 1392. My dad was deaf, on air, and quite as light as air. In his very soft shoes, how he could dip and glide and skip and slip and slide. In his very soft shoes, I used to stand and watch him every day. He was always smooth and cool. I used to love to hear the people say he's a regular dancing fool. He barely touched the ground and never made a sound, but I've noticed in all his reviews that when he took his bow to the crowd and the crown, the crowd went crazy and the host came down when Daddy wore his very soft shoes.
Thank you.
Halt. Who's there? Friend or foe?
Friend.
Oh.
I hope. Oh, Harry. Harry, look at me. I was trying to run away, but it was only because I thought you didn't love me. I thought you didn't love me? But even if you don't love me, I can't love anyone but you. And I want to be near you, if I can, for as long as I can. Oh, Harry, I don't blame you if you've changed.
Well, in a way I have.
Yesterday I loved you as never before. But please don't think me strange. I've undergone a change, and today I love you even more. My heart cannot be trusted. I give you fair warning. I openly confess. Tonight I love you less than I will tomorrow.
Yesterday I loved you as never before, but that was long ago, and now it's best you know that today I love you even more. My heart cannot be trusted. I give you fair warning. I tremble at your touch, not nearly half as much as I will tomorrow morning.
Yesterday you seemed as lovely to me as anyone ever could be. Now I see what tricks my eyes can play. Yesterday I must have been utterly blind, or else I was out of my mind, for I find you so much lovelier today.
My heart cannot be trusted. I give you fair warning.
Yesterday
in a little while,
I loved
just a little while,
as never
you and I will
before,
be 1, 2, 3, 4.
But that was
in a little while
ago,
I will see your smile,
and now
on
it's
the
best
face and eyes on to be forever happy.
I love you even
is the
more.
Way I have it planned.
My heart cannot be trusted. I give you fair warning. Tonight I love you less than I will tomorrow morning. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
And one small pea that I had to bring all the way up from the kitchen pantry, all the way up the most killing stairs in the kingdom. Well, all right, you can come in now. Did you bring everything? The
yes,
hypnotic
madame.
Mirror?
Yes, madame.
Oh, good. And the rest of the things? And the girl, where's the girl? Don't you think she'd be dropping from exhaustion? Oh, it's you. All ready for bed? Mm-hmm. You must be sure to get a good night's rest for your trip back to your kingdom or wherever you're going. Oh, bring the incantation. Silken swishing cymbalance wraps us in a gentle trance. Deep in Morpheus's arms we lie, off we go to Betty by.
You know, I think I'm getting a sty right here.
Bring the poppy, Mandagorensis, please. Drowsy incense, sweet aroma, wraps us in a gentle coma. Murmuring voices seem to say, Mr. Sandman's on his way. Oh, that ought to get us to sleep, shouldn't it? The sleeping draught.
There's more.
Here, drink a little warm milk and opium extract before bed. As I always say, drink it down. Oh. Now, I'm certain you're going to have no trouble drifting off, but just in case, I've prepared a special treat. Bring on the Nightingale of Samarkand. Who has the Nightingale of Samarkand? Oh. Naturally, I have to do everything myself. Get her out.
Okay. I'll be right here.
Birdie. All right, Birdie, sing! Stop! You were brought here to put a live princess to sleep, not wake a dead one. All right, let's have a lullaby, Birdie, nice and soft. Oh, yeah, verily. Now, my dear, why aren't you in bed?
Am I almost there?
Hover up! I'm sure you're the only one in the castle that's going to get a good night's rest.
What are you, some kind of nut?
Here, darling, let Mother fix it.
Hey, let me do it. I can do it myself.
Well, far be it from me to interfere, precious.
Hey, I said I can dress myself.
Well, why are you wearing that so early in the morning?
Well, today's the test, Mama, and I want to look my best for when...
The test?
Mm-hmm.
The test is all over, sweetheart.
Huh?
The test is over, darling boy.
Well... When was it? What was it?
We put her to bed on 20 soft, downy mattresses with a pea underneath the bottom one to test her sensitivity. And the pea would have kept a real princess awake.
She slept?
Well, I'm sure I don't know, darling, but she was practically falling asleep before she got into bed last night and yawning like a vulgar scullery maid. I mean, she looked ghastly, darling, and old enough to be your... Well, we'll see.
Oh, Fred.
I'm sorry. I'm just so nervous. I could die. Absolutely die.
You must control yourself. Dean could be here any minute.
Shh. If she doesn't pass, I don't know what I'm going to do.
Here comes the queen.
Are you new here?
Yes.
Watch closely. I take a perfectly plain piece of parchment with no cuts, folds, creases, or concealed pockets. Oh, I've never gone this far before.
Yes!
Oh.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Your Majesty.
All here to see the princess on her way, since she's such a favorite of ours. And I've made sure to give her an extra special consolation prize. Sir Studley?
A very thoughtful gift, Your Highness.
Charming, charming. Dauntless? Dauntless! Dauntless! Where is our little slug abed? You'd think she'd be on her way. Oh, here she is, and she's not even dressed yet. She must have slept like a baby.
37,429.
What? Shape! What do you stuff your mattresses with? Dousing equipment! What do you mean?
I mean that bed ought to be moved down to the torture chamber.
You didn't sleep?
I never even shut my eyes!
Oh, you passed!
Passed what?
You know the test! Mama put a pee under 20 mattresses and you felt it! And now we can't get married!
Yes!
No. A pee?
Now don't you think she's pretty?
She's not pretty, she's beautiful.
Oh, 20 mattresses! No wonder I'm black and blue! Dauntless, I'm gonna leave the wedding arrangements up to you and I would start looking around for a small kingdom because I've got a feeling we won't want to live with the in-laws.
Oh, well, she's gonna get cold sleeping on the spare table. I better take her up to our room.
Dauntless, wait!
Wait for what, Mama?
To give this matter proper consideration.
Well, she passed the test, Mama.
And I said wait. Now you listen to your mother. Throughout this heartbreaking business of trying to find a true princess, I've never nagged, never interfered, and never expected one solitary word of sympathy.
Shh, Mama, quiet.
And I will not stand by and watch you throw yourself away on this little nobody.
Shh, she's sleeping.
I mean, she may have passed the test, but I say I've never trusted anyone with those shifty eyes or that mean little mouth.
I told you to shut up!
The prophecy. It happened! The mouse devoured the hawk!
Look, the queen can't talk.
I...
What?
I can.
The king speaks!
And I've got a lot to say. Unhand the boy.
Well, good night.
You may go. Now you've asked for an Agravain and you've got it. From now on when I say hop, I want you to hop. Hop. Skip. Jump, hop, skip, jump, hop, skip, twerk.
How did she say away that he was awfully small?
But it wasn't the pee!
It wasn't the pee, it wasn't the pee at all. Oh, life is grand, it's very interesting. We think we understand, we know it's very interesting. Thank you, Christmas, and Christmas, we love you so. For a princess is a delicate thing,
Anybody else? Anybody see Alex. Shady Man?
Alex. Shady, go. Go,
Ever since I came here from Mountain Vista sophomore year, I came here junior year. This has been the most amazing experience of my life. I don't know what I'm gonna do next year, but you, all of you, are gonna continue this, and you are going to get out there every play and just kick butt like we did tonight. And it's gonna be amazing.
Amen!
So I just want to say thank you to everyone who helped me to do this role and helped me learn how to act a little better. So I just want to say thank you.
This was a great show where I could be with my sister and have fun, meet a lot of new people. It was a great experience, and this last show was perfect. And the Legend Legacy will continue. This isn't the end for the seniors.
I love this theater department. It means the world to me. These people are my family. Do everything for me. We've gone through hell and back. They're great. I love them. This program for 6 years now, and I've never met such amazing people in my entire life. But I don't know where I would be without them. And oh, it's gonna be weird without them gone next year.
I'd just like to thank them. This has been an awesome experience, and I have never done anything really like this before. And it was just wonderful, and I really liked it. So yeah.
Guys, I had a great 4 years here. It was a pleasure working with all of you, and my most fun memories will be with you guys. Thanks.
This experience was basically probably one of my fondest memories that I've ever had being in the theater, and especially because I got to be right alongside my brother, which was really nice in my senior year. It's definitely a show to remember with all the craziness that has happened, but I'm really grateful for the opportunity to play a character that's really out of my comfort zone, to be completely honest. So, I'm Clarity Engel, signing off.
My cast and crew, they're just so amazing. Like, I could never ask for a better group of people to work with. It's just been so great. And I can't thank them enough. I wish I could do more shows with them, but sadly, this is the last one. I wish everyone the best that's going off to college. And I can't wait to work with everyone else in the future.
This cast has just been, it's really been my second family. Like, I don't know what I would do without all of these crazy people in my life. Like, it has been such an amazing experience to be with and meet all of these new people. And otherwise, we wouldn't have gotten to know each other without theater, and it's just truly amazing how close we are and everything.
Everyone's a joy to work with. Couldn't imagine anybody else working with. Just all the leads have been superb, and everything about it has been great.
Especially those.
It's just so much fun to come after school and just be a part of such a program, and it's just so much fun, and I wouldn't trade it for the world, and I don't want to cry, so it's been awesome.
These people are probably the greatest people I've ever met in my life. I really found my place at Legend here, and these people are always so welcoming, and they're so easy to work with, and they build you up whenever you need it, and I don't know what I would do without them.
There were some difficulties throughout the play, but I'm glad we were able to resolve them, and it was really cool seeing how we were able to come together and resolve the problems that we needed to fix, and I'm really glad I was able to be a part of this.
Good job, everyone! It's a great show. It's probably the best musical we've ever done, and I look forward to next year.
This whole production was so amazing. The cast and crew are so amazing, the cast especially, and the crew too, because we couldn't have done it without that absolutely magnificent set out there. We're only as good as the worst cast member, and I can say pretty much that all of our cast members are so, so great. It was just a fantastic show. And I moved here from Mountain Vista 2 years ago, and I can say that these are the best people I've ever met. This is the best theater program ever, and the best school ever.
I just want to say
say thank you so much for this amazing opportunity. This is my first time auditioning for anything, and you guys just made me feel so welcome, and you've just become such a family. And I hope that we can just carry on your tradition as our seniors are with
you. Hi, everyone. So I'm kind of a mess right now, but that is only because you guys, we have made such a family here at Legend, and every single one of you means so much to me. I have so many memories with every single one of you. We have created bonds that will never be broken, and even though I'm gone next year, I will come back and I will support every one of you, because our shows in the future years are going to be so great based on what we have right now. So thank you for supporting me. You have no idea how much this show means to me. Thank you.
Every day she walks in and she says to me, what can I do? What can I do to help?
It isn't about what's going to make her feel better. It's about what's going to make the rehearsal run more smoothly. And when you're coordinating this many people, there's always something. And she gives, and then she gives some more. And it's not because there's a golden dollar at the end of it. It's because she really, truly believes in this process. And she watches the magic and helps create the magic. And I hope that you can continue to create the magic, because you have a heart for this that not very many people do. You're awesome, Kate. Woo!
So take the photographs and still brings in your mind.
Every day you greet me with a smile, and if I have a rough rehearsal, you text me after and you're like, are you okay? Can I do anything? And it's people like you that we need more of. You're so supportive, and you're so genuine, and you care about every single person in this room. And I love you, and I hope that one day you just realize how amazing you are, and that you can see yourself the way that all of us see you, because you're unbelievable.
That we really do appreciate what you do. We may not always act like it. Stress at the moment. Okay, be nice. But the reality is, it's very clear that what's happening back shows off in the front. It's just the audience doesn't see it. And I really appreciate how much magic there is because of what you do. It's awesome. So. Look at this group of people, because we have the pleasure to work with you guys today, and it is always fun to work with people who develop their skills. The level of commitment you see here, some of these people, Lauren, I don't know what I would have done without you this year. You know, it's just bottom line. But the reality is, these are big shoes to fill. I hope all of you are eating your Wheaties and working out regularly, because the shoes will be filled. They always are, but you never know from where. I guess to remember that the best compliment I think I ever got was when I graduated from high school, and my director said to me, you know what? You'll truly be missed. I say to each one of you, you will truly be missed. Very special.
Thank you. I love you.
Right now, we are putting on one of the strongest productions that Legend High School has ever had. If you look at the technical aspects, if you look at the acting aspects, if you look at everything that we're doing right now, it's a culmination of the past. And every single year, we continue to grow stronger because of the seniors that lead us. All of the seniors that have stepped forward previously, you guys need to know that your impact on the students below you is going to follow through the rest of Legend history. Okay? What you teach the juniors will teach the sophomores, and the sophomores will teach the freshmen. And it will continue. And you will always be here. It's called a legacy. Don't discount the things that you do, because the actions you make in this theater are important. Know that you have had an effect on all of us, and that you will be seriously missed. Thank you.
Some of you guys I've had since you were, Seventh grade, because Cimarron and Legend started together, and that was my first year with you guys. And just watching you guys grow up has been amazing, absolutely amazing. You're my own children. And I wish I was here more for you guys, but juniors, sophomores, freshmen, I look forward to the next however many years until you guys graduate. But you guys have done an amazing job, like always, with the show. I'm sorry we're not doing pause. We didn't plan the pause dance this time, so for the seniors that missed it, I would always think about you. And you guys are beautiful and wonderful and talented, and I cannot believe how much you've all grown and come so, so far. I am so proud of you, and I'll remember each and every one of you. And I love you all, and just have an awesome fun, and be crazy with the dance stuff. Just have a blast with it, as much fun as you possibly can. Will you? As much fun as you can?
Oh yeah!
Yes?
So, way back when, back in my day, I started this back in fourth grade, and I wanted to act, but I had terrible stage fright, and so figured, what else could I do? So I started doing sound, and well, here I am. And so now I'm not, don't have as much stage fright, and it's been a pleasure working with y'all.
Love you! Love you! Every time I come in, you guys are well rehearsed, and so not only do I appreciate your hard work for doing it, but without her guidance and her writing down every step, which it's hard to write down dance steps.
I think my brain
I can't even read my own. But thank you so much, sweetheart, for your help. I totally appreciate it. And you've helped to make the cleanliness of all the choreography. It's owed to you as well. So
I like you, Fred. I like you.
You're just saying those words to be kind.
Oh, no, I mean it. I love you, Fred.
He is out of his medieval mind.
I'm perfectly sane and sound. I've never felt better in my life. Oh, everybody come and meet my incipient wife.
Me?
You!
Oh, hi! My name is Fred, hi!
Peaches, oh!
Hello, Peaches!
I'm in love with a girl named Fred. My reasons must be clear. When she shows you all how strong she is, you'll stand right up and cheer. I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She drinks just like a lord. So come sing a merry drinking song and let the wine be poured.
Fill the bowls to overflowing, raise a goblet high.
I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She sings just like a bird. You'll be left completely speechless when her gentle voice is heard. I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She wrestles like a Greek. You will clap your hands in wonder at her fabulous technique. Whoa! With a girl named Fred, she dances with such grace. You are bound to sing her praises till you're purple in the face. I'm in love with a girl named Fred. She's musical to boot. She will set your feet a tapping when she plays upon her lute.
Bravo, bravo, bravissimo, bravo, bravissimo.
tread. A clever clownish wit, when she does her funny pantomime, your sides are sure to split. I'm in love.